To all my gorgeous people out there, it's Amin over here, and today I have come up with this black smoky eye look. This. So if you're new to my channel, please do take a moment to subscribe. It'll mean the world to me, and hit the bell icon so that you don't miss out on any new video that I upload. I have been like forever wanting to do this video. I had done one and it by mistake got deleted, and then I had one collab with Swati. I will be linking her Instagram down as well as her YouTube channel so that you can check it out. And I had done a collab with her. I'll be linking that also down so that you people can go check that out. So basically, we had done one black smoky eye video collab together. Unfortunately, it got deleted. So I wanted to do that creation and show you people how easy it was. Basically, I learned from Swati that it can be done so easily, so easy. It is so simple and people obviously love it a lot. Black smoky eye is the most basic of all makeups. Like, each and every person loves black smoky eye, and few people are very intimidated and very scared that, oh my god, it's a black smoky eye, it won't look that great. Black smoky eye looks good on everyone, each and every individual. You guys should try it out and see how beautiful it is. Just the techniques are so simple in this. So without any further ado, let's get started. First step that we are going to do, regardless of anything, is moisturizing. So I'm taking this Pond's light moisturizer, non oil fresh feel moisturizer, this one over here. So for primer, I'm taking this Lakme Blur Perfecting Primer. Today I feel like just applying primer everywhere. My skin is feeling a little sensitive and I don't want, you know, the foundation to be sitting on a very sensitive skin. I basically shaved my face yesterday. My skin after shaving, it stays sensitive for 2-3 days and it's perfectly fine for me because it happens. So the next step, I'm directly going to go in with eyes as usual. I'm just going to allow this primer to sit. I feel that the more amount of time you give a primer to sit, the better, flawless the skin will look. I have brought you guys closer so that you people can see, and I'm taking this L'Oreal Infallible Full Wear Concealer in the shade Amber. I'm going to use this concealer today to prime my eyes. So now that my eyes are concealed, I want a base. For a base lid shade, I'm going to take this very soft brown color. This is from Nykaa K 23 eyeshadow palette. I'm going to take this color over here and just set my entire eye with that. Once our eyes are set with this brown shade, you can either take a gel eyeliner or kajal pencil. Just take a black gold pencil. Today I'll be using this Faces Canada Magnet Eyes Kajal. This one over here. I absolutely flippin' love this kajal. It's so pigmented. So what we are going to do is, we are just going to roughly like just draw all over, because any which ways you're going to be blending it out. So what you're going to do, our crease line is there, little bit above that I'm going to draw. Now that we have drawn that line, I'm just going to roughly fill in. So now that we are successfully look like a cartoon character that has just had a bomb blast, I'm going to take a very flat eyeshadow brush. So I'm just gonna like start blending and buffing this out. So once our eye is done, what you're gonna do is, you're gonna set the deal with a black eyeshadow. You can use any sort of black eyeshadow. I'm gonna take this Nykaa K's 23 palette eyeshadow again. Like, this is a very basic, handy eyeshadow palette. You can never go wrong with this. You can use this like a contour. You can use this like a blush, because you get 4 matte blushes in this. And you know, you can also use it like if you're, it's a very travel friendly option. So if you want to set your face, you can set it with this shade. And you know, if you're forgetting your eyebrow pencil, you can use this. Like, legit, this will do the job for you. It's such an amazing palette. So I'm gonna take this black shade over here. I'm just gonna keep stamping it on like this. Okay, so now that we have done this, what we are gonna do is, we're gonna go back brown shade again. Like the one over here, like this brown. What I'm gonna do is, like this top portion that we have, we are just gonna buff out that portion outline. A lot of fallout, because black generally has a lot of fallout, but this eye is complete. This is a little intense smoky eye that I'm going for, and I usually like taking it like till this end because it really gives a good look. Next, what I'm gonna do is curl my lashes and apply mascara. I'm gonna use this Lash Sensational by Maybelline. So I'm gonna quickly go off camera, do this. I'm gonna just pop on few lashes, and for lashes, take the most dramatic lashes that you have, because you know what, your eyes are gonna be so heavy, your lashes, if they're gonna be thin, it won't look that great. So I'll be taking these eyelashes. I'll be right back. So I finished my other eye also. So far, loving how it's looking. I know it's a bit dirty, we have to clean that up. Don't worry, there is nothing that a concealer cannot cover or hide, okay? So what we are gonna do is do our eyebrows. So for eyebrows, I'm taking this Miss Claire eyebrow pencil. This is in the shade medium brown. If you're looking for an affordable brand of eyebrow pencil, look no further. This is so good. You get a spoolie along with it. Like, what else can someone ask for? My eyebrows are done. So the next thing that they're gonna do is our entire face. I'm gonna take this foundation from Wet n Wild. This is a Photo Focus Finish foundation. This is in the shade Golden Beige. And for concealer, I'm taking this Maybelline Fit Me in the shade 40 Caramel, and I'm going to be applying that. Make sure if you want a clear cut line, keep dabbing your concealer and make sure you just cut the eyeshadow in such a place that you know you get that exact cut. I'm just going to do that. So I'm just going to take little more concealer. I want to lighten this under eye of mine, so I'm going to be taking this L'Oreal Infallible Concealer again. This is in the shade Amber. This is a tad bit lighter for my skin tone, so I use to brighten my under eye. Can you see the difference between this eye and this eye? How brightened this looks. I really love it when your eyes are awake and you look amazing. So I'm going to set my under eyes using this N by Base compact in the shade Easy Mohair Look. And I'm going to set my rest of my face using Lakme Rose Powder with sunscreen. And this is in the shade Warm Pink. I love the coverage that this compact gives. It's truly amazing. I'm gonna take the same Faces Canada Magnetized Kajal and fill my waterline as well as the upper portion there on top. After we are done with that, I'm gonna take the same Nykaa K palette. I'm gonna take this shade and do my lower lash line with that. And always make sure your corner of the upper side and lower side, they are joined, not separate, look that flattering. And so to complete off my lower lash, I'm going to use this L'Oreal Volume Million Lashes. This is a fabulous mascara for your lower lashes. It just separates and gives that different dramatic look. For bronzing up my face, I'm gonna take the Sugar Cosmetics bronzer in the shade Taupe Topper. Yeah, I'm going to take blush. For blush, I've been lately loving this Maybelline contour palette, the blush in that that they give. That this blush, I know it has a bit of sheen, but that sheen acts like a highlighter too, so when we move, that glow is something else. Can you see how gorgeous that is? I love this blush so much. It just gives that fresh look to your face, which I absolutely love. I've gone overboard with it. When they're using so much of an heavy eye makeup, please don't go overboard with your blush. I'm just gonna like remove the excess. I'm gonna take Laura Geller highlighter in the shade Rose Glow and I'm gonna apply it. I'm gonna take this Wet n Wild lipstick. This is in the shade Sandstorm and this is the lipstick over here. What a gorgeous lipstick. Yeah, this has a very terracotta nude kind of color to it, like a very warm terracotta nude. So guys, this is my completed look and I love how this turned out. Oh my god, this is so beautiful. Anyone can do this, it is such a simple thing. You all you need is a kohl and black eyeshadow and a brown eyeshadow. Three things and you can do your entire eye with that. False lashes is very easy to apply once you get the hang of it. If not, you can just put a coat of mascara, that also is going to look brilliant. But if you're going to put lashes, please do use only dramatic lashes because your eyes are heavy. And if you're going to use a subtle lash, it's not going to look good. So it's better you use a heavy duty eyelash like I'm using right now. I hope you guys like this look. If you did, don't forget to like, comment and share. And if you're new to my channel, please do subscribe. If you want me to do any particular look or you want me to review any product for you or you want me to do any sort of series, you can just like comment down and I would happily do it for you. And all the products I've used, the links will be in the description box so that it will be easier for you people to go there and check it out. So I will see you all in my next video. I love you all. Bye.